Hi everyone, Pete Calamain here. I hope you're having an awesome day. So how do you design the layer stack for a four-layer PCB design? That is what I'm going to explain to you today. What you see over here is a layer stack visualization in Altium Designer for a four-layer PCB board. There's a top overlay, there's a bottom overlay, and inside I always tend to use two planes, a power plane and a ground plane. So today I want to show you, based on a template document, how you can define it and set up your board before routing and doing all your layout work. So for that I'm going to include a link over here to this page. All PCB suppliers typically have one of these templates. This is from Eurocircuits. So what we are using in the example today is the classic C4 layer PCB doc. You can go ahead and download that, and then you have the immediate stack up for that board. Other suppliers have these as well. I'm not linked to Eurocircuits in any way, but this is a nice example to use. So let's dive into it and I'll show you how to do that. So you can do that manually by entering the layer stack specifics manually. I'm going to show that. Or you can use manufacturer data. So that's based on documents from the manufacturer and importing that. And for that, you can import the board layer stack and it will automatically include the design rules as well. So manually, how does that look like? You go to layer stack manager in Altium, if you're using Altium. In other software, there will of course be an equivalent for that. So here's the layer stack. So what you see here is that two layers are used, two signal layers. Let's assume that we want to add, that we want to make a four layer design. Insert a layer. Okay, we insert a layer above, below the signal, and I want it to be a plane. So I'm going to make a ground plane and a supply plane like this. Then it has automatically added a layer one, a layer two. I can call this ground and this VDD. Now what is interesting as well is that the thicknesses are added on here, and you will see that the complete thickness now of our PCB is 0.6. So you can go ahead and look it up with your PCB manufacturer to see what the exact thickness is of every layer and to put that correct. Now let's say that we want to have 1.6. This is not correct what I'm going to do here, but it's a quick workaround just to put the exact thickness of the PCB. So I've used 1.3, and so we get a total thickness of 1.6 and a bit above. 1.6 or 1.55 is a standard. So you can go ahead and save that. And then what you will see here is that we have a top layer, ground, supply, and a bottom layer. And as well, our PCB is now much thicker than it used to be before. And you see, of course, I've made the dielectric in between very thick and the others are very small. That's not the correct way to do it. It would be more interesting to use the layer stack provided. But what you see over here is that it nicely fits in between. This casing is made to fit a 1.6 millimeter PCB, and you see that it lies on the edge here, and then there's some clearance left on top. So interesting stuff to quickly do that. What is also possible, and that depends a bit from manufacturer to manufacturer, is that you use a PCB doc provided by the manufacturer. And that will have the correct settings immediately. So this is from a supplier that makes PCBs, a PCB doc. It's a four-layer PCB doc. So you have a bare PCB. So the first thing you would need to do in there is define your board outline. So we can do that manually or via DXF. But what is interesting here as well is if you look at the layer stack. So we already have here on the bottom top layer, mid layer one, mid layer two, and bottom layer. And you see that this is already nicely defined. So with the correct thicknesses, of course, the naming you can still change. You see the total thickness is 1.55. So we have the exact layer set. That's interesting if that is available to use it. So I hope this video was helpful for you, how to design your layer stack out for a four-layer PCB. If you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comments below and I will be happy to help. If you like this channel, feel free to subscribe or give this video a like. It would mean a lot to me. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.